There's a terrible phenomenon that destroys otherwise good relationships. I call it the relationship death gap. This is what happens. The more masculine partner in the relationship, that's the one who prioritizes logic over emotions, is okay with something. Could be anything. Maybe he or she wants to go out with friends even though his partner is sick in bed with the flu. Or maybe he wants to invite his ex-girlfriend to his birthday party. Or maybe a million other scenarios. Whatever it is, his more feminine partner, the one who's more feeling-oriented and emotionally connected than he is, feels upset about it. And if her upset isn't immediately understood and validated by him, she gets even more upset. He may not have actually done anything yet, but just the fact that he doesn't validate her upset and instead defends his logic for being okay with whatever the thing, well, that's even more upsetting to her. Even if he agrees to stay home or not invite his ex-girlfriend, just to get his partner off his back and not because he really wants to or understands her feelings, it hardly matters. She remains upset anyway. And now he's pissed too, but doubly so, because not only is he angry at himself for giving in to something that doesn't make any sense to him, he's frustrated that she's still not happy after she got what she said she wanted. Sound familiar? This is the relationship death gap. And it kills relationships slowly, sometimes fast. But here's what's really going on and what to do about it. Naturally, his logic works for him. His reasons make perfect sense to him. He knows his ex-girlfriend is no threat. He knows he loves and is committed to his partner. Let's say he even believes that a man who can stay friends with an ex is the mark of a generous, loving man. He could believe that. His current woman should be proud in that case, in his mind, to be with such a man. Anyway, he sees the countless things he does every day to prove his love for her, so there's no reason for her to worry or object. Yet none of this matters to her. Her past experiences, and her biology, can cause her to feel insecure about his ex. She may not feel genuinely fully considered in his logic either. What's worse, if he can't validate her feelings because his reasons make more sense to him than her reasons for being upset, now she feels unsafe with him because she can't trust that he truly cares about her feelings, which she experiences as not caring about her. So he sees what he sees, she feels what she feels. She can't convince him to change his thinking and he can't calm her emotions with his logic. The more they both try, the more defiant they both get. And this is how the same argument can play itself out for months, even years, as the relationship death gap grows. It's maddening to the masculine partner who thinks what happened is long over. He might even still think the offense was only imagined anyway. But as long as the feminine partner continues to feel that her emotional experience has never been fully embraced by him, the disconnect grows until no connection remains. Two good people swallowed into the relationship death gap. So how do you close the gap? Well, it's simple, just not easy. Because you gotta suspend your viewpoint for a moment and dive into your partner's experience. The more masculine partner needs to embrace her feelings, even if they don't make logical sense to him. In fact, if you can give up needing her feelings to make sense to you, and I mean ever, just learn to accept that her feelings are real for her and communicate that you support her feeling whatever she feels. Most things will go much better for both of you. All she wants is to be validated in what she feels, to know that you don't think she's crazy. And I know her reasons for being upset might make her seem crazy to you. But so long as you orient towards her as though she's crazy and you fail to embrace her feelings, she'll feel that too. And she's gonna be hell for you. She'll either get louder or she'll shut down altogether, and you don't want either of those outcomes. On the other side, the more feminine partner can really try to understand his logic, even though it may hurt. Seriously, accept that he's sharing his reality, and in his reality, he never intends to hurt you. If you think he's lying or he does want to hurt you or he just won't ever take responsibility for how he affects you, you probably shouldn't be with him. But if you do trust that he genuinely wants to be a good man for you, then assure him you really get that, that you know he never means to harm you, because that's almost certainly what he's aching for you to get. Tell him you can see his good, or at least innocent, intentions, and he'll feel seen and understood. His resistance will relax because he no longer feels the need to keep proving himself to you. And look, I know both of you are worried you're going to lose something. Your freedom, validation, connection, your identity, your sanity. But notice, in your resistance to each other, to embracing each other's reality, you're losing all that already. You gotta understand, you two are never gonna experience life the same way all the time. Tiny gaps of misunderstanding will continue opening up between you for the rest of your lives together if you're committed to being real with each other. The trick is not to get rid of gaps forever, but to learn how to close them quickly before they can drain your intimacy of all affection, care, and even respect for each other. And what's surprising is that as you learn to embrace each other's reality without denying your own, often whatever you were fighting about just stops being a thing because you stop being enemies. You can trust each other to have your back. Which doesn't necessarily make the ex-girlfriend at the party decision obvious. But if you're the feminine partner, you just might be surprised how inspired he is to really take care of you once he gets that you genuinely appreciate his point of view. And if you're the more masculine partner, you'll be surprised how much she lets go because she trusts you. And she even follows your lead because she feels that you're going to really care about her feelings, whatever may come. So I hope that's helpful. If it brings up even more questions, I'm a relationship coach. I've been through this. I understand the experience very well. Feel free to reach out to me through my website at brianreeves.com. That's Brian with a Y, reeves.com. And let me know what this inspires you in the comments below. And definitely share this with anyone you know who might be caught in the relationship death gap.